Now, what's up, everybody? My name is Mike Brown, aka Review King MB, and I am here to talk about, to review, and revisit Independence Day. Yes, Independence Day is a 1996 film that was directed by Roland Emmerich, and the plot, come on, do I really need to talk about the plot of Independence Day? I'm pretty sure everybody has seen this film. It's an alien invasion movie, basically. And throughout the film, you're following several different characters, humans, who we're seeing them deal with this. Not just deal with this, but they're trying to figure out how they're going to combat this, fight this. Stand up for America, for all of mankind, on the 4th of July. Now, what I think of Independence Day is, I have an interesting relationship with this film because I think most of us remember when this movie first came out. Remember when the trailer of this movie first came out, the previews, and just how blown away we were by what we were going to get. This was like the first of its kind as far as big summer blockbuster films, just big budgeted special effects, and just like total escapism, seeing something you've never seen before on the big screen. There's so much, I think, to be had from watching this film, especially when I was a kid. I loved this film when I was a kid. A lot of fun, but a lot of scary moments as well. I think it had everything. And then, a couple of years ago, I rewatched this for the first time in a while, and I was just like, wow, it's so cheesy, it's so corny, the dialogue is bad, and there's so many unbelievable plot points that I was down on it rewatching it. But watching it again now, look, it still has all that stuff. It still has the cheesy moments and the corny dialogue and the weird plot points. But I appreciate this movie a whole lot more watching it just now for so many reasons. Let's talk about this. Jeff Goldblum as David, the computer guy, basically, because that's what you cast Jeff Goldblum as in any movie. He's the guy who knows everything or has to figure everything out because he's good at that. He's great at that. Also, you have Bill Pullman as the President of the United States. And I think everybody thinks of Bill Pullman as the President when they think of him as an actor. And if nothing else, it's for that damn speech. That awesome speech, one of the greatest movie speeches, I think, of all time. He might be the greatest movie president of all time, because not only for that speech, not only because he's proactive, but at the end of the movie, he's with everybody in the air, flying the ships and shooting at the aliens. Like, he's in there. Fucking A. Will Smith as Stephen Hiller. This is what you think of. When you think of Will Smith, you think of this is his big break. This is his breakout performance. This is what made him, catapulted him into being a movie star. And he never went down after this. Just summer hit after summer hit. He was Mr. 4th of July. And I think it all started here because he's great in this film. He is. He's so funny. He's so charismatic. He's so likable. And that's what you want from a main character. Because if you had cast anybody else besides Will Smith to do this role, to say these lines, to do some of this dialogue, it would have completely fallen apart. It would never have worked. But Will Smith, he comes off as so likable. Nobody else would have been able to pull off the Welcome to Earth scene. Like, literally punching the alien, knocking the alien out, smoking the cigars and saying, now that's what I call a close encounter. Only Will Smith can get away with that shit. It's so true. As far as some of the other characters, we have Randy Quaid. And that's where you get to the silliness, the goofiness. Look, I like Randy Quaid. He's a funny guy, a fun guy. But I think all of his scenes here don't fit this movie. It's so goofy. He's this crazy drunk guy that nobody believes his story about how he was abducted by aliens 10 years ago. And he's just a drunk. He's a fuck up. His kids are disgusted by him, embarrassed by him. Even his main son, who looks like Keanu Reeves. I swear they thought this kid was going to be a big actor because they gave him a bunch of scenes here. It's just, I don't really like anything about the Randy Quaid stuff here. Even at the end, when he sacrifices himself, I just go, ugh, go away with this character. I'm sorry. The smaller character is Harvey Fierstein. Is again an example of just a little too goofy, a little too over the top. We're cracking jokes when fucking aliens are trying to kill us. Vivica Fox, she's fine. She really is. The only problem isn't her fault, but there's the scene where she's in a tunnel and she's with her son and their dog, and the aliens have first attacked, and there's a big, like, firestorm coming, killing everybody. And they're trying to get away. They're running. She kicks open a locked door. And then runs in there. The dog at the last second jumps out of the way of the fire. And that's where you get the Roland Emmerich-isms. That's the stuff that when I watch more of his recent movies, I can't stand. I can't stand how he has these scenes that are supposed to be for tension, but they're clearly just over the top. And it's like, okay, you know there's going to be a certain amount of characters who won't die. They're untouchable. They have a force field around them. And that's what Roland Emmerich likes to do. Some people might like that. I roll my eyes. Judd Hirsch plays Jeff Goldblum's father. I like their dynamic, their relationship. Now, that's the humor that works because it's more natural. You should have saw my shock and surprise when I was looking up the cast of this movie. And the little girl who plays the president's daughter in this film is Mae Whitman, who some of you may know from The Parenthood or The Duff, a movie that came out pretty recently. I'm like, wow, how did I not know this? That's crazy. But I think where this movie works the most at, because yeah, some of the characters are hit or miss, some are really good and some are sort of corny, but it's the special effects, it's the spectacle, it's the big budgeted type scenes, like the scene where the ship first arrives on Earth and it comes in the sky, hovers over the whole town, just completely, like, you can't even see the sky, the ship is so big, and everybody's reaction, shock and awe, they don't know what to do with themselves, they're scared, going crazy. That's the scenes that work, that type of, holy shit, if that was me, how would I react, what would I do? That's some of my favorite stuff there. Obviously, where the aliens launched their first attack on us, and they're destroying big landmark type buildings, the White House being blown up. That's something that this movie has to get credit for, being the first film to blow up a notable landmark building like that. The White House especially, it blows your mind to remember back and seeing a movie do that for the first time. Sure, nowadays we're used to it, we get it all the time, but I think that's where, like I said, I appreciate it more, going back and seeing all those moments. Also, there's some creepy horror movie-like scenes as well, like when they're in the science lab and the alien becomes awake again and then communicates with the humans telepathically through the scientist with the weird hair. And it's just, that's a horror show. That scared the fuck out of me when I was a kid. Or the end battle where they all go in there. Although I will have to say that it's a little goofy when you see Jeff Goldblum configure a computer virus, and that's how we combat the aliens. A computer virus. You just go, really? I want to give this movie more credit, and then it does something like that. So look, are there bad moments in here? Are there cheesy moments in here? This movie could have been perfect, and maybe it falls short on that, but I still think it's enjoyable. It could be a little bit of nostalgic running in there, but I still have fun with this film. I still respect this movie, or I still give this movie credit for a lot of things that it does get right. Anyways, guys, let me know in the comments below, what do you think of the original Independence Day? Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. Later!